Yo, what is up, people? It is Tangi, and we are back with another Overwatch video today. It's gonna be another uncut commentary, and we're just basically gonna be hopping into some rank, talking about some shit. And as by the title, you guys are going to see, we are going to be talking about the Ana nerf a bit, because I'm kind of sad about this nerf, to be honest. I didn't know they would, like, break her that hard. I already thought that, like, not that the grenade nerf was a huge thing, but it's still, like, it affected the way that she played, because she couldn't really, like, half HP heal someone with her grenade anymore. Because basically before, what you could do is just throw a grenade to tanks, and it would just basically, like, fucking, I don't know, it just basically, like, you wouldn't even have to shoot, like, two shots. It'd just basically be, like, you shoot the grenade, and you shoot a shot just to finish that, like, 20 HP left on a tank, and it just, like, basically fucking, that's how it'd go. So, yeah, and then, yeah, we're gonna go play some Widow, because that's just what we are, dude. We're a fucking Widow main, what you wanna do? So, yeah, they're, like, basically just fucking nerfing her grenade again. Not on the healing part of it, on the damage part, which I'm really not happy of. Because, it's actually a very good aspect that she had to her grenade, that, like, a little bit, a damage that she had with her grenade. I don't know, it was just a perfect amount of damage, just to sometimes, like, finish off enemies. And now it's gonna be harder to, like, play that hybrid Ana, because basically what Ana is that she's a healer, but she also, when you're good with her, people that are good with her, they come into a, like, section of where Ana is, like, a hybrid, because you can play her as a DPS at the same time as playing as a healer. And that's why she was so skill required, because you had to heal and do DPS at the same time. Basically what they're nerfing here on Ana is her part of DPS, because now her grenade doesn't do a lot of damage, and her basic shooting attacks with the poison effect will not do that much damage either. So that's why her, like, big part of it getting fucking nerfed so hard. And it's just kind of a sad part, to be honest, because, like, she was a very, very skill required hero to play, and I don't know, that's just what it was. And now she's gonna be even harder, because, example, you want to play DPS on at the same time as going as a healing on, then it's gonna be harder. You won't be really able to do it, because, to be honest, to put out the damage anymore, it will just be pretty much, like, almost impossible. So, I mean, the damage will be a problem. So, that's what, like, a big part of this video I just wanted to talk about. And I don't know if you guys want to tell your opinion in the comment section once this video is done. But it's just, I don't know, man. For all you Ana mains out there, you could leave your fucking opinion on this. I'm not too mad about it, to be honest. I'm really, like, I don't know, I'm really on both sides for this. Oh my god, she's so low! Oh my god, dude, I'm so done. But, bro, I don't know, it's just, I'm kind of on both sides on this, because I know she did a lot of damage, but she was, like, you had to have skill to, like, put down enemies with her poison attacks and stuff. It's not like it was an easy thing to do. She remains that, she's a sniper, and, you know, that's just what she will stay. And I don't know, that's just what it is. So the Ana nerfs are definitely coming, even though people are, like, fucking mad as shit about it and do not want the nerfs. I mean, it's like the D.Va, man, she had the nerf anyway. Oh my god, we were playing so terribly. I'm legit trying to concentrate as much as I can on, like, talking right now. And, yeah, it's just basically, like, the fucking, I think it's gonna be a good nerf. She's still healing as much, she's still gonna heal, so that's just what I want, and I don't want to go away. But, yeah, it's just gonna be different now, because, you know, I played the hybrid Ana as well, or Ana, whatever you guys want to freaking, whatever you guys call her, and, it was just a very cool aspect because, you know, it's the only healer that's actually like a burst healer and you could use as a DPS as well, but not really as a DPS because she was hard to use the DPS, so that's what it basically is. So otherwise, it's gonna be a weird nerf, to be honest. I wonder how much the damage will actually the nerf will be or will make an impact. I'm actually really curious because now when I'm gonna play on it, it's probably just gonna be some healings and some heals and stuff. So because me, like before, what you could do is pretty much like go on a hybrid Ana and basically carry your team just by like going DPS as well as healer. But basically, like what people would do is that they would go DPS Ana at the same time of healing, because you could you have both abilities to do DPS and heal. So that's why it could carry a team sometimes, and which why he had such a like she had such a great ability to carry teams. And it's just sad that it's going away, man. I don't know, and I just hope that Bastion's gonna be fucking out of this meta soon, because he's a huge problem in the competitive community right now. To be straight up honest, I am not the biggest fan of it. It is really starting to get on my nerves, because now each game that I actually go in, I'm literally going against Bastion, and you practically have to play Bastion to win games now. So this is really a huge problem, and it has to be like something has to be done about it, to be honest. And thing is, I watched a video of Lone Hawk earlier, and he was talking about like how you know, Blizzard always puts people, like they want people to be good in the meta right now, well in the meta right now, always in the meta, and you know that's why they bring people, they bring the buffs and the nerfs sometimes to make them less good in the meta. So because basically Ana was like 100% picked in every other like competitive game. If you were like in high competitive scenes, up in like Master and stuff, people were very, very like, well, they are in very much in the meta. So like they'd always go for the Ana pick because she was like the best healer. But now, this will bring back the other healers. I think Mercy's gonna be a huge, huge part of this competitive four season now. Because she's basically like the other like very good healer that there is apart from Ana. And I don't know, it's just things are gonna switch up a bit. It's gonna be kind of weird because we came into the phase where Ana was a very good healer, and I don't know, I've never experienced that part where Zen was actually huge. Oh my god, I'm so bad. Why would she double freeze me, dude? That is so stupid. Well, we're playing so bad right now. Seriously. Alright, I'm gonna try to go for like a try-hard ending here. Because we're about to fucking lose this shit right now. I'm actually doing like shit. And my team is... oh my god. They were back capping it for like a couple of seconds. That would have been cool if they would have gotten that tick. But yeah. Other thing for the trope series that I think I will be doing is tutorials on how to do certain stuff that are complicated in the game. And basically that's what we're gonna start by, and yeah, that's what we're basically gonna start by, because those are the like only types of videos that I have in mind right now for trove, just to start the series as soon as I can. Not to just get rid of it, just to like, you know, just because that's what it is. And bro, I hate fucking Bastion. I hate Bastion. What? He was still in tank mode? Bro, that thing lasts for so long. I'm so done with that, man. Alright, well, I'm sorry, guys, but it's Bastion meta, dude. That's all I have to say. Bastion meta is like a huge problem right now, man. There is nothing else that you can play aside from Bastion as a DPS now, because this man is like the only choice that you have in terms of fucking big ass DPS and to win games now. It's basically what it's at, and I'm very frustrated about it because Bastion really isn't a skill required hero. Alright, this is kind of retarded, to be honest. I had no teammates over here with me. Alright. Oh well, I'm probably gonna lose this game. I don't really care anymore right now. I really did not focus this game. It's really hard to try to play an Overwatch game at the same time and talk about stuff. It's fucking hard. I don't know, dude. I need to, like, find something, or just get fucking used to it, to be honest, because it's a really fucking hard thing to do, and I'm just trying to fucking focus and shit. So, if I want to start making some good gameplay, I need to just start fucking focusing. I'm gonna try out some fucking Ana. I think I'm just gonna end the video here. I just wanted to, like, kind of discuss the Ana nerf with you guys. I don't know, on which side I am for this nerf. To be honest, because it's pretty much useless to, like, you know, trash talk about fucking Blizzard and stuff when they're making a nerf and stuff. Like, it's not gonna change their mind. They're still gonna keep the mindset that they have for this, and basically by just saying some shit about them, they're just gonna basically, like, make them to, like, ignore more your comment and stuff, and it's just what it is. So basically, all the nerfs, guys, fucking let's just deal with it and see where the game goes. Thing that they definitely have to fucking get out of this game right now: Bastion, way too much. He's way too much, and they need to do something about him. And the Ana, I just really hope I'll be still able to play her, because they're playing putting the nerf down, I'm not gonna, like, stop playing her or anything. I'm still gonna be playing her, seeing her if she's good and stuff. And, yeah, it's just another update video on the trove stuff. I'm just gonna probably make tutorials on how to play certain classes, which is something that not a lot of people, make tutorials about, and I have some interesting stuff to show you guys as well that I didn't really see from other people. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and as always, my people, have a wonderful... Why is this game so fun? Dude, I swear this is the funnest free game that I have ever freaking played. Look at my hands on me right now. So hey yo, what is up people? It is Tangi. Let's go for the corniest fucking outro right now. No, I'm just kidding, but seriously, guys, yo, I don't know what I was gonna say. So the game that you guys actually saw in the intro is actually this free game that they put on PSN this week and or this month. And dude, it is so stupid on how this game is addictive and fun. You have to grind so many hours.